Got the finish roughing in the bodywork on the front of the Mercedes, the front fenders and the hood here. So we're just giving it, finished off an 80 grit right now. We're giving it its first coat of filler primer. So we'll give it two coats. So we'll let that first coat sit for a second. And in that time, I can show you Brent's truck, the little 71 Chevy Halftime. So we'll come around this way and get out of the fumes. Making noise. If you remember, on the last few videos, you've really been concentrating on Bruce's 31 Model A with the Hemi in it. But in the very last video, I showed you Bruce's car when it was all finished being painted. At the beginning of the video, you saw me spraying the underneath of the cab. I had the cab flipped up on the firewall, and I was doing the underneath of it in a satin black finish over top of the texture spray. Pardon me, I'm a little high off the fumes right now. I'm losing it here. Anyway, so here we are. We painted it. We got the cab all painted. This is another one that I painted here. All I did was wet the floor down and paint it here. As I explained a video or two back, my painter who I use the booth, or who he paints for me sometimes, all depends. He's out of town, so I don't have a booth for the next couple weeks. So I painted the cab. Obviously the cab was off the frame. So we painted it over in the other bay, wetted the floor down, and here we go. This is it. This is the color that Brent picked out. It's an absolutely gorgeous color. I don't know how well it's going to show up in this video. It changes color quite a bit. It goes from like a dark green to an emerald green. And when it's in the sunlight, if we ever get any sunlight here in Chilliwack, it goes to like a beautiful, I can't even explain it. The truck has got like a pearl in it, like a yellow pearl. So it just, it's like a fireball coming at you, I guess you'd say. You're going to need sunglasses for this one, Brent. Anyway, so here it is. I dropped it on the frame today. We just lifted the body up in the air with the hoist, and we set her on the frame. Now, I bolted it down on the frame, but I didn't tighten it right down, because you have to remember when you're doing a project like this, the door's not on, the front sheet metal's not on, so it's best to probably just snug everything up, because believe it or not, even how tight you're going to go with the bolts on the cab is going to allow for a little bit of adjustment on how things are setting up. So I kind of just snugged it up, and once everything's in place and lined up, then we'll go around and do the final tightening then. So so that's it. I don't want to say exactly what color it is, because some guys don't like people to know what color the vehicle is, because they want to keep it to themselves, because they're hoping they're the only one that's going to have that vehicle that color. But so I won't give it away, but it's a beautiful color. Brent's gonna send the truck down, and when it's all done, he wants to have it wet sanded. It doesn't need to be wet sanded whatsoever. All it really needs is just a little, there's the odd little speck of dust here and there. Like I told you in a couple other videos ago, it doesn't matter whether you paint it in a booth or not in a booth, you're always gonna get a little speck of dust. And usually what happens is, before you get your car back from the painter, they polish it out. And you never know. So, I mean, Brent could get away with polishing out the odd little speck of dust and just leaving it. I mean, look, I don't know if you can even see it in the video here, but I mean, look at the reflection on this. It's just unbelievable. It's base coat, clear coat. It's gorgeous. And wet sanding is like a final step. Like, wet sanding is taking the vehicle to I guess, unless something new's come along since I've been out there, wet sanding is taking the vehicle to the top of the limit. Like, that's it. You don't go beyond wet sanding. All vehicles, whether they're new, old, whatever, when they're coming out of a paint shop, if you look at them, even the cars on the lots today, or when you're next time you're driving around and you're at a stoplight and a vehicle pulls up next to you, take a look at it. They all have a little bit of texture, or orange peel, as we want to call it. They all have that, some more than others. And that's what wet sanding does. Wet sanding, you'd start with probably 2,000 grit. And with water, obviously you buy special sandpaper for wet sanding, and you start scrubbing it with 2,000 grit, and then you do a polish with a proper abrasive polish, and then you do a cut polish, and you do a wax on it, and it just eliminates all that little bit of orange peel that possibly could be showing, and it makes the thing just look like a sheet of glass. It's like looking into a mirror, and the depth is right there. Like, it's purity is all I can say to you. It's just purity. But Brent really doesn't have to wet sand this truck. He wants to take it to the last limit, so there we go. Some body shops out there that are painting vehicles, they need to probably wet sand their vehicles at the end of the day, because they don't care how they paint them. It's sad to say, but there's two different types of people nowadays, in my opinion. This is only my opinion. I'm not insulting anybody out there. It's just my opinion. There's painters and there's applicators. And I know a few guys that can do absolutely gorgeous paint jobs that work in body shops, and they just slap the paint on any way possible. And you look at it, and I know they can do way better. And I'm like, why do you do it like that? And they say, because they work in high-end shops, you have to understand too. And they say, well, it's going to go and get polished anyway. It's going to get wet sanded and polished, so who cares? And it's just like, yeah, but you're making that guy's job harder because you're not making the paint flow out as nice as it should. And not only that, the vehicles all take time to put together. This truck is going to still a couple months away. So even though I know Brent's going to wet sand this thing, I don't want to just slap the paint on any old way possible and say, yeah, I don't worry if it's got dust or runs or chunks hanging in it, because he's going to wet sand it, it'll all come out. That's not right, because what do I do in the meantime? Well, I've got other customers and clientele coming over here, and Brent himself coming over here looking at the vehicle, and they're going to look at that and they're going to be like, oh my God, what is that? So, like I said, I'm not insulting anyone out there. There's guys that are really good and they're painters and they know how to paint and they'll get a beautiful job like I've done here. And there's other guys that are applicators that'll just, they'll just throw it on and they really don't give a shit because they know it's going to get sanded out at the end of the day anyway. And I don't know, I feel bad for the polishers because they're just making that guy's job a lot harder. But anyway, I hope you're watching this video, Brent. There's your truck. I hope you love it. We're going to get on to the next few steps here and get her going. And away we go. So anyway, guys, I have to take off into the other bay. I have to get back on the Mercedes and give it another coat of primer. So it was good talking to you all out there, and thank you for your responses, and I will see you next time. Okay.